welcome to Bhavna's Kitchen. Today I'm making flaky buttery croissant rolls without eggs. The first step is to prepare the dough. You already know the recipe of dough. I just prepared the dough very simple, as if I'm preparing the dough for pizza. So let's start. Here I have lukewarm water. You should be able to dip your finger in and it should not hurt. To that, 2 teaspoons of active dry rapid rise yeast. And I took 1/3 cup of water. Sugar, just whisk it. Cover it and let it stand for 10 minutes. 1.5 cups of plain flour. To that, 1 tablespoon sugar. Salt to taste. Give it a good mix first to all dry ingredients. Here I have oil. I'm going to add about 1.5 tablespoon of oil. Mix it again. Let's check the yeast. You can see that it has got nice and foamy. And now, using the yeast mixture, prepare the dough. Knead the dough. Take regular water if you need more water to prepare the dough. Alright, so here I have the dough ready. Take just a little amount of oil and smooth out the dough. Now spread oil into the bowl all over. Place the dough inside the bowl. Coat the dough with oil as well so it does not build up any crust. Cover the bowl with a plastic wrap. So the dough is ready and I'm going to let this dough rest for about 1 hour or until you see double in volume. Alright, it's been more than 1 hour and the dough has risen nicely. And now comes the buttery part. Remove the plastic wrap. Punch down the dough and onto the clean surface, dry flour. And bring the dough and knead it about a minute or so until it's nice and elastic. Alright, so look at this dough. Take a little bit more flour and roll the dough about 1/8 inch thin. The thinner you roll, the flakier the croissant rolls will be. Now here I have room temperature softened butter. I'm going to spread on here all over. Make sure it's not melted. Should be softened enough. When done spreading butter, sprinkle a little bit of a dry flour. What this will do is that it won't let butter ooze out when you roll again, especially if the temperature is a little high in your kitchen. And now fold in just like a puff pastry. I usually spread a little more butter on this layer as well, but this is totally optional. A little bit more flour and then fold in again. And keep dusting flour, otherwise it will be hard for you to roll and you don't want this dough to stick on the surface. So take your time to follow this process. Again, I'm going to roll. And this time I have rolled about 1/4 inch thin and again, just a slightly little bit more butter all over. Dry flour again. Again, folding just like a pastry. And just folding again. Perfect. And again, I'm going to roll. And this is the last time I'm going to roll. Now you can roll rectangle, circle, square, however you like. Alright, so I have rolled this into 1/4 inch thin circle. And now cut just like a pizza into triangles. And now roll them into crescent shape. Just stretch a little bit to make it bigger and a little more thinner as you go through. You can roll it again if it shrinks shape. I'm going to finish making all of them. Arrange the crescent rolls into the baking tray and I have used parchment paper. So here I have all the croissant rolls ready. Now I'm going to let this rise again. The second rise is also very important in order to get fluffy croissant rolls. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to cover this tray and let it rise again about half an hour or until you see them again double in a volume. Preheat oven at 375 degrees Fahrenheit. All right, it's been more than half an hour. So let's check how the croissant rolls look like. And look at them, they look so beautiful. They have risen so nicely. So now it's time to bake. And the last thing I have to do is brush these rolls with milk to get the nice brown color on top. The oven is ready and this baking tray is ready to go into the preheated oven, 375 degrees Fahrenheit oven. And bake until about 14 minutes or until the top of the rolls look brown. The croissant roll has been baking for about 14 minutes and ready to take out. Look at them. Look at the color, looks so nice, golden brown color. And they already look flaky. Let me show you the inside of it. Without even any eggs, look at how flaky layers and look at inside of it. It's a great pleasure in eating freshly baked breads. Can't tell you how good it is. So this was all about preparing egg-free croissant roll recipe. Thank you for watching and I will see you soon with another great recipe. Have a happy baking!